to talk to you about constructing or making your own sewing machine repair and cleaning kit. I do say sewing machine repair and cleaning kit. I use those words simultaneously simply because often you'll find if you simply clean your sewing machine, especially your vented sewing machine, you've also repaired it. So some of the tools are basically the same. And this is just what some of the tools that I found useful. You, of course, in your own kit may include other items, but this is simply what I have. Here I have an old sewing machine case. I like it because it snaps open. I have this one open just for ease right now, but it snaps open on the sides and it closes really easily. It's convenient. It was an old case that wasn't being used, so I'm using it. It has a lot of depth and height. So let's just get started. So I've removed the cover from the old case, and this is what you have revealed. I have boxes. This is why I like to use the old sewing machine case, because it has height, so I'm able to snugly fit box components in there nice and neatly. And in each one of these boxes and the bottom tray, I have all the items that I use for repairing or cleaning my vented sewing machines. And I'll just briefly talk about some of the items. Alrighty, so on that top layer inside of my cleaning and repair kit, simple little box. I use this to store my dirty rags in or to sit items in while as I'm working and cleaning or repairing the machine. Just nice and convenient. I have another little Ziploc bag which contains all of my cleaning pads. I have muslin sheets, pieces of felt, and I also use these convenient little makeup pads. And again, they're simply for cleaning, you know, to wipe down the machine, you know, as I'm going, the makeup brush pads and the pieces of muslin and felt work good for that. Okay. Inside of this box, this here, I have compressed air in a can. And this is used to blow out lint, dust, you know, dust bunnies, form particles that have gotten lodged inside the machine. You know, use it in the bobbin area to blow out components. This particular Veneto machine, the 185J Singer, the top does not lift off, but on most Veneto machines, you will unscrew the top component and you use this again to blow out areas. And the head over here and underneath the machine. Can air, again, used to blow off foreign particles from the machine. Some vintage sewing machines require that the actual motor gets lubricated. Find yourself a really good motor oil specific to sewing machines, or that's safe to use on sewing machines if you have to actually lube the motor. Review your owner manual to see if that's required. Sewing machine oil. You're going to have to actually oil the machine after it's clean. So you're going to need a good sewing machine oil. And then these components would fit nice and snugly back in. Okay. Another box that was in my sewing machine and repair and cleaning kit. I like to put a lot of extra leftover sewing machine parts. You want to have those handy, of course, just in case you need them. So if you have a lot of sewing machine parts like I do, keep them handy in your cleaning and repair kit for obvious reasons. And I just keep them in a nice Ziploc. This is another little box I have. You're going to want to have light bulbs absolutely in your cleaning and repair kit simply because a lot of the bulbs go out and you want to have them convenient. So this is just a nice way to store all of those items that I need for repairing. in the bottom tray of my sewing machine and repair and cleaning kit, I have all the other items that I use for repairs. You're going to want to have a flashlight, of course. So the sewing machines themselves are going to have a light, but sometimes just to get down in crevices and to see, you're going to want to have your own flashlight. So keep a flashlight. This is an absolute must. This is a oil remover. A lot of times on the inside of the machine, you'll find oil that's coagulated and clumped up or gotten hard, and you're going to want to use an oil remover to loosen up that oil, especially in the head. This is the main tool you're going to use to actually get up all of that oil and gunk. And the oil and gunk is usually the main culprit that's preventing your machine from operating properly. So you're going to want to have that definitely in your machine. I use Febreze just because after I've cleaned up my machine, I want to take one of my makeup pads and just lightly spray it and wipe the machine down so it smells nice and newer, nice and clean at least. Inside this little box, it fits nice and snugly inside of my component here. Again, in here you'll find extra sewing machine parts, but let's talk about some things you actually need for cleaning. Different screwdrivers. I have a series of different screwdrivers, all different shapes, all different sizes. You're going to want to have an assortment of different screwdrivers available, simply because there are different screws that you'll have to unscrew and fasten back as you're cleaning or repairing your machine. So you want to make sure you have those on hand. Just like light bulbs, there's nothing more annoying after you've cleaned your machine and you want to test it out and you don't have a needle available and a wound bobbin. So those are some items you want to include in your sewing machine and repair kit. You're going to also want to have different types of brushes. Just like the can ear, they're very useful in brushing out and getting rid of dust, bunnies, particles, threads, or whatnot. When you're cleaning the dowels, tension dowels on your machines, if you have some dental floss available, you can cut off a piece and run it through those dowels to clean out, to get all that lodge dust out of there. So you want to have a set of dental floss. Tweezers are also very handy. They come in handy when you want to pull out thread that's lodged. You can't get out any other way. Tweezers might be handy. This is a soldering gun. And I use a soldering gun sometimes if I have to repair. Usually I have to repair on some of the older sewing machines. I don't know why the spool here will be broken or missing. So I either have to repair it or attach another one. So having a soldering gun in your kit is a very useful tool. And those again inside of here are just extra screwdrivers or whatnot. Along with the bobbin and the needle, make sure you have at least some type of thread in your kit. And sometimes I have to repair cords, so I keep electrical tape inside of my sewing machine cleaning and repair kit, just in case I need it. Okay. So again, I like to have everything nice and neat and handy when I get ready to use items. So I've found that a sewing machine case is ideal because, again, it has the height. It gives me the ability to stack all of my components nice and neatly inside one general area that I have easy access to when I'm ready